What's up, peep squad? Peep squad is in the building, baby. Please like, comment, subscribe, share the video. It'll be greatly appreciated from the bottom of my heart. My peeps, my peoples, peep squad is in the building, baby. Let's get down to the situation. Let's talk about Black Ink Crew Confessions. It went down on VH1. But one thing about Confessions, they didn't talk about everything. They didn't talk about the situation with Fly Tatty and how he departed from this earth playing Russian roulette, allegedly with Bella, that's on Black Ink Crew Chicago, or she was, and she was there in the room, and actually Fly Tatty ended up having two wounds on him, you know, which caused his death. Like, that's crazy. If he's playing Russian roulette, it's only supposed to be one, you know, shot fired or whatever the case may be, but allegedly it was two shots fired at the same damn time. And you know, Ryan Henry came out and accused Bella of actually having something to do with the situation when it comes to Fly Tatty, and he addressed it on Instagram and he was very upset. And also Bella, she came out and said, that's wrong, why would you say that, that was my boyfriend, I was dating him, I watched this happen, I'm totally hurt. And you already know how Bella get down, so you guys let me know what you think about that situation. So they didn't do all they needed to do when it came to the confession situation. But Ryan said right now with the pandemic going on, he learned a big lesson how to have more business and, you know, basically being more of an entrepreneur too as well. He wanted to, you know, spend, you know, quarantine time when the pandemic first hit with Rachel, but Rachel wasn't hearing it, and him and Rachel are just friends. It's done, it's finito between them, allegedly, but nothing's ever done when it becomes between Ryan and Rachel. And Four says that he was making his money on the street, baby. He was out here putting out music, and he has his fans only page doing his thing out here. But also, Four does have a baby on the way with Nina Austin. I was like, oh, shoot. So, you know, this is Four. He got a baby on the way with Nina Austin. He's singing to the baby in February, you know, singing to the baby, rapping to the baby about their relationship. So, you know, he's doing what it do when it comes to hustling. And also, he's talking about stocks and bonds and things of that nature. They need to get into that cryptocurrency. ARP is the way to go, allegedly. And also, you know, Bitcoin is also the way to go, and also Ethereum too as well, allegedly cryptocurrency, because ARP is going to be okay when the court rules on the situation. But in any event, Black Ink Crew guys and the fathers are talking about entrepreneurship, investing, stocks and bonds, and basically get that money popping and get that money rolling. So it is what it is with that situation. And Ryan is basically trying to live his life. He's trying to do the best that he can do right now. You know, he's single, ready to mingle. And Mark Lamont Hill was trying to hook up Ryan with Miss Kitty. That ship didn't sell long time ago. Miss Kitty and Ryan are just friends at this point. And if you ask both of them, they'll tell you that nothing ever happened between them two, even though Ryan put the tea out there on the show. But allegedly, it's just for TV only. So you guys let me know what you think about that situation. Also, in Confessions, they didn't talk about the situation with Ryan, you know, cheating with, you know, his best friend's girlfriend, that which was a part of, you know, the family clique. You know, that could be one of the reasons why him and Rachel is finito and done with the situation, because Ryan was out here in these streets with his best friend's girl. He was doing, and the best friend girl, you know, she was cool with Rachel. So, you know, you got all that situation going on, and they didn't talk about that. So it's not really much of a confession. We got Don, he is doing his thing, he is handling his business, he's opening up a gym, and actually he was there for Ryan and he was supporting Ryan through his thick times, his troubling times, and everything of that nature. He returned the favor, him and Four returned the favor to Ryan, because Ryan was going through some things because he couldn't spend time with his kids. Rachel was dissing him, he was sleeping in the shop. So Four said, you gotta check on your strong friends. And amen, you know, Four and Don has checked on Ryan, and Ryan is no longer their babysitter, and Rachel is finito and done with Ryan. Of course she would be. The girl that she's been on vacation with Ryan been sleeping with her, like, Lord have mercy. Of course she was too done and too through. And they talk about Miss Kitty and what she's doing now, and Miss Kitty's going doing her makeup thing. She's getting into acting, and she does not have a relationship with Black Ink Crew whatsoever. She's done with Black Ink Crew because you know what? They hurt her. You know, they wasn't her friends. They lied on her. And also, she says that, you know, looking back, when people want to be in a position that you are in, you know, they get jealous of you in your position, try to take you out of your position because they, the whole time, they've been wanting to be in your position. So she's talking about Donna. She is talking about, you know, all of the girls over there. I was like, Lord have mercy, she's going in. So basically, when it comes to Miss Kitty, she's not feeling the crew, you know, from New York at all. She don't talk to them, and she ain't got nothing to do with them. Young Bae, she ain't dumb. She's done with Young Bae. She hasn't talked to her either. It is what it is over there. I was like, Lord have mercy, it is going down. So Miss Kitty's back in Washington handling her business and trying to get through because, you know, she's still, you know, suffering from the pain of losing her mother. But also, you know, Mr. Lamont Hill was trying to hook up Miss Kitty with Ryan and trying to get them together. Ryan talking about he want to be married. Miss Kitty talking about she want to be married. They trying to play these games. And we know Miss Kitty and Ryan ain't even trying to be on that level, point blank, period. That's not where they at right now today. So, shame on Lamont Hill. So, you guys let me know what you think about that situation. I was like, damn, it is going down. So Miss Kitty's handling her business. Then Charmaine, she comes on, and Charmaine is highly upset, and she's feeling a certain type of way when it comes to Jess. She's not liking Jess at all. And then also Charmaine, you know, she addressed, you know, Don, and she addressed Four because she was feeling a certain type of way about Don and Four, and basically she didn't want them around in her circle. She didn't want to be bothered with them, and basically she was really upset when it comes to Four because Four was out here, you know, not giving Charmaine her props. Charmaine said that she invited, and she basically, she was out here hustling to get Four on Big Jam in 2017, and when he didn't give her the proper accolades, Charmaine was pissed off about that situation. And basically Four was like, he was working on the hard times too. He was working on the back of the scenes. He was up there meeting with people. He was up there performing. He was doing everything he could do to get on Big Jam too. It wasn't just Charmaine. So basically he's saying he ain't trying to give Charmaine no credit, and Charmaine keep it moving, and he wish her the best of luck. But until then, he don't got shit to say to her. I was like, Lord have mercy, it is going down. And Charmaine was really pissed about the situation. I was like, damn, Charmaine's upset. Charmaine's feeling a certain type of way. She is going in. So we got that situation where Charmaine is pissed off, Charmaine is upset, and but she moves on because she clearly has another target, and her target is, you know, Jessica. She's not feeling Jess at all. Jessica, point blank, period. I was like, what is going on with this situation? So these two ladies ain't getting along at all, point blank, period. I was like, oh shit, Jess, you know, she came with the shits, and basically she wasn't trying to get dogged out, and she was talking back to Charmaine and saying, Charmaine, like, come on, you begged me to be here, you wanted me to be here, you basically wanted me to be a part of the show. And then Charmaine started to expose Jess, basically saying Jess wanted to get paid as much as Charmaine, and Jess was out there talking to producers in the UK going against Charmaine. And also Jess asked, you know, Charmaine, do you think they will fire Ryan and put me as the lead for the show? And so basically Jess wanted to, you know, lead the show, be the queen of the show. And Charmaine was not feeling the situation at all, point blank, period. And Charmaine said that she was going around saying that she owned the shop. And Jess was like, girl, you know, you introduced me to the world as your business partner. Because Charmaine was asked, how come you didn't let Jess, you know, make decisions, you know, when you hired Miss Kitty? And Charmaine was like, she was never my business partner whatsoever. And Jess was like, girl, you told me and you told everybody on the first episode that I was your, you know, partner. Yeah. And so when it comes to Charmaine was like, girl, I ain't never said nothing. Charmaine is too much. And Charmaine basically is just getting it in, you know, towards, you know, Jess, basically saying she thinks she's the boss. She wanted to be the boss. She wanted to take credit for things that she couldn't take credit for. You know, she didn't put work in this show. She act like she owned everything. She act like it was her shop, it was her business. And Charmaine basically was like, I'm done with her. Like, you know, Charmaine basically said that she went to the producers and the production company and basically introduced them to Jess and tried to get Jess a job and tried to get Jess on the show. And Jess was like, "And you know, because I'm the best." And Charmaine was like, "I wish I would have really never did that." She was trying to help her and try to promote her. And then Jess goes, "I thought about women in power. What about girl code? What about us, you know, standing together as sisters?" And Charmaine was like, "You was trying to get me fired. You was talking bad about me. You was trying to get my pay cut. You was trying to do this. You was trying to do that towards me. I don't want to hear it." And so, you know, Miss Kitty was like, you know, she didn't make no, Jess didn't make any sacrifices like the rest of the ladies. And Jess was like, "Yes, I did. I made all types of sacrifices. I came on this show. I left my family back in the UK. And Miss Kitty was like, "We've been through hell and back on this show. You don't know what we went through." And Miss Kitty went through some shit from New York to Chicago, you know, almost getting into altercations, spraying mist, almost getting jumped, getting accused of sleeping with Ryan, and basically being treated like ish by C's, being fired. And, you know, Miss Kitty was like, they thought that she was gonna come running back, that she was gonna try to be a part of Black Ink Crew New York. And Miss Kitty said, "Nah." And basically Miss Kitty is telling Jess, "You didn't put in work, you didn't go through the things that we went through, and you want this red carpet." I was like, "Lord have mercy." And Charmaine was like, "Yes, Jess thinks she owns the world. Jess thinks everything should be given to her. Jess is very entitled. Jess didn't do no work. Jess didn't put in no work." I was like, "Lord have mercy." They was going in on Jess. And then, you know, Charmaine was basically like, "Oh, look at her talking all this ish right now." And Jess was like, "You know, whatever." And then Charmaine was like, "Come down here and say it to my face. You don't want to say it again. Come on, come on. Don't play with me. Come on, come to Chicago." Jess was like, "Ain't nobody afraid of you and your empty threats." I was like, "Lord have mercy." And, you know, we went down the road with Charmaine and her mother and the loss and her baby and things of that nature. And then when Charmaine was explaining her hurt and her pain, Lamont Hill, he just broke down crying, because earlier that day before filming the confessions, Lamont lost his father. So, Lord. And then Lamont had COVID, and also, you know, Ryan Henry had COVID. So, yes, it's a whole lot going on. There goes Charmaine's beautiful daughter. And it is what it is. We got the situation with Four. You know, the young lady mother that accused Four of actually being her baby daddy. You know, he doesn't have any contact with the mother or the daughter. And basically, he heard the daughter be running away. You know, she's dealing with a lot of turmoil. So it's really a sad situation. But Four has moved on, and he got a baby on the way with allegedly Nina Austin. So it is what it is. And basically, he's focusing on his music and getting back into that situation. It was just too funny, because when Charmaine basically said, "Yo, listen, Kitty, you see Jessica talking all this mess," Miss Kitty was like, "Yeah, I know, she's talking all that ish while she's a whole pond, a whole river, a whole lake away." I was like, "Lord have mercy." And it was getting at Jess was basically like, she is not coming back to Chicago because she's gonna open her own shop. She's not gonna work for anybody. And also, you know, she would like to work with Ryan. Ryan said he'll work with her, but Ryan is not feeling her. The whole crew is not feeling Jess that's on the stage at all. They feel like she's an opportunist, and she's also shiesty and shady. So you guys let me know what you think of the confessions. I was like, "Lord have mercy." It was going down. Like, Charmaine was getting in Jess' ass, and Jess was talking all types of ish. Jess was basically like, she ain't afraid of Charmaine, and she don't care about the situation. And she was like, you picked me, you called up on me." I was like, "Lord, she is doing too much as usual." And then we get on to, you know, Ashley and Don. They are working it out. She still got Don, and Don is her husband. She ain't gonna never leave him. He ain't gonna never leave her. They're gonna continue their relationship, continue what they do, baby. And she realized Don is a good husband, so she's gonna keep him. Lord have mercy. Their marriage been going up and down, so I guess at the end of the day, they gonna keep it together. Amen. Thank you, Jesus. Miss Kitty is doing her thing, and she don't really got nothing going on with Jess friend that visit the show, whoever he was. So the ladies was definitely not feeling Jess whatsoever. Jess is a problem. Jess is a situation. And it seems like Jess may not be returning to Black Ink Crew Chicago at all, because she is not wanted, and there's no storyline, and nobody really wants to film with her, point blank, period.